Orange isopods, Porcellio scaber, orange morph, can be fed to various species of reptiles, amphibians, and other animals. They also serve as an effective cleanup crew in naturalistic vivaria, hermit crab habitats, and other animal enclosures. Their omnivorous appetites can reduce uneaten food, keep fungal growth in check, and even help outcompete pesky grain mites. While they can be added directly to a vivarium, it is advisable to maintain a culture of isopods outside of the vivarium as well, especially if your vivarium contains organisms that eat the isopods. Culturing is a simple matter. A plastic container with a fairly snug but not airtight lid is recommended. Various sizes will work. A 6-quart container, such as this one, is ideal. The substrate consists of a base layer of 1 to 2 inches of coconut fiber and a layer of leaf litter and pieces of wood. The leaves include oak, maple, sea grape, and magnolia. The woods are maple and oak. I collected the wooden leaves in a forest near my home, but I baked them at 350 degrees Fahrenheit first, for at least half an hour to kill any possible hitchhikers. I missed one side of the container as needed to maintain high humidity in the culture. The isopods will eat the leaves and wood and will in fact breed on this diet alone. However, productivity of the culture is higher when additional foods are provided. Most vegetables and fruit are suitable. For example, squash, potato, carrot, and mango are popular with isopods. Be sure to give small amounts of this sort of food, as large quantities of food cannot be eaten quickly enough to prevent mold outbreaks. It is also a good idea to provide a source of calcium for healthy exoskeleton growth. Small pieces of cuttlebone, which is sold for use as a supplement for pet birds, work well, as do pieces of shell from a boiled egg. After mating, female isopods will develop a brood pouch on the ventral surface of the body. The young isopods develop in this pouch and are released when they are mature enough to fend for themselves. They look like small, pale replicas of the adults. Every few months, remove about half of the substrate and replace it with fresh coconut fiber and leaves. The old substrate will contain isopods of various ages, which can be added to a vivarium or used to start a new culture in another container.